Hi and welcome. I'm Ola and I'm working as a field application engineer at Acconeer. Today I'm going to show you how to install our evaluation kit. This is the agenda. First, preparing what you need to install the EVK. Second, we connect the hardware. Third, installing Raspbian, which is the operating system for the Raspberry. After that, we transfer the Acconeer software to the Raspberry Pi. And last, connecting to the Raspberry Pi and run one of the demos.
We have two different EVKs. We have the XC111 and we have the XC112. The XC111 consists of the sensor mounted on a reference board and also the connector board. The XC112 consists of the reference board, the connector board, but also a flexi cable. What I assume you already have is a Raspberry Pi, SD card case, and the SD card. Also, you need a power supply to the Raspberry. To retrieve the IP address, you also need a keyboard, a mouse, and a monitor.
Now it's time to connect the hardware. We start by putting the reference card into slot 1 of the connector board. After that, we connect the connector board with the Raspberry Pi. And last, we connect the USB cables of the keyboard and mouse into the Raspberry.
To connect the XC112, make sure you have the blue side of the flexi cable up. Then we start by connecting it to the connector board. After that, we connect it to the reference card. The blue side is up on both ends. Then we connect it to the Raspberry Pi. And this is how the end result looks like.
Now it's time to install the Raspbian OS on the micro SD card. Put the micro SD card into the SD case and then into the computer. If you get a question about formatting the SD card, press cancel. I'm doing this on a clean installation of Windows with some programs installed. For example, Etcher, which is used to flash the Raspbian OS, which I've also here. Etcher can also be installed if you're using Linux or Mac. Since I'm using Windows, I've also downloaded PuTTY, which is used to connect to the Raspberry. I've also downloaded WinSCP, which is used to transfer files to the Raspberry. If you're using Linux or Mac, these programs are already available as SSH and SCP. Let's start Etcher and flash the Raspbian OS. Now we drag the Raspbian OS image to Etcher. The SD card is already default, and I can just press flash. If there is a permission box coming up from Windows, press yes. If there is another popping up, press cancel. And Etcher is currently flashing. This will take a couple of minutes, so just be patient. When the flashing is done, just close the program. And then pull out the SD card. Put the SD card into the Raspberry. Plug in the monitor and the power supply. The Raspberry will boot automatically. After booting, we start the terminal window we type sudo raspbian config. Here we go to item number 4, localization options, and you select the time zone that is appropriate for you.
Once again, enter localization options. Go to item number 4, change Wi-Fi country, and select the appropriate country.
After that, you go to interfacing options and you enable SSH, SPI, and I2C. Let's start with SSH. Then SPI. And last, I2C. After that, we finish by pressing Tab and then Right to finish. After that, we connect to Wi-Fi. Then we update the Raspberry with the latest software. Sudo apt-get update. This is to fetch the information about the latest software. And then we upgrade to the latest software. Sudo apt-get dist upgrade. Capital Y to confirm. And then we reboot to see that everything was installed smoothly. Type sudo reboot. Now you get a warning that SSH is enabled, and that is totally fine. Press OK. Let's start a new terminal window to find the IP address of the Raspberry. You type ifconfig wlan 0. And here you see, at the inet, I can see the Wi-Fi IP address. Please write it down, and we disconnect the monitor, the mouse, and the keyboard, because now we are able to connect to the Raspberry without these. Now it's time to download the Acconeer demo software. So let's start the WinSCP. As the host name, you type the IP address that you found earlier on the Raspberry. In my case, it's 172.20.0.164. The port is the default one, 22. Username, PI. And the default password for the Raspberry is Raspberry. R-A-S-P-B-E-R-R-Y. Login. Here's the security warning. Press yes or update, and then we're logged in. On the right, you can see the Raspberry. On the left, you can see the local computer. So here on the local computer, you select the directory where you have the downloaded Acconeer demo program. In my case, it's on the desktop. Here you can see the Acconeer demo program. Let's transfer it. and it's been transferred. After that, we connect to the Raspberry via PuTTY. Same thing as the host name, choose the IP address. And then you press open. Another warning, press yes. Log in as PI and the password Raspberry. If I type ls, I can see all the files that are currently present on the Raspberry. And as you can see, these files, they match what we see here on the right side. Since the Acconeer demo program is a zip file, we need to unzip it. Then we enter the directory with cd evk. From here, we'll execute our detector distance. So I'll type ./out example detector distance, and then I'll tap complete. Pressing enter. And here we can see that no object is found all the time. It runs continuously. And when I put my hand in front of the sensor, we can see that the number changes. So currently, I'm holding my hand 230 millimeters from the sensor. The number in parentheses you see is the amplitude. It's how strong the signal is. And that's all for today. Thank you very much for watching, and let me know if you run into problems.